everybody, welcome to today's video about aromatherapy to reduce back pain. Today I'll explain to you how you can use aromatherapy to relieve your back pain. And hey, listen, I know that back pain can be very annoying with the nagging lower back pain from morning to night, 24 hours a day. Now, to get rid of this back pain, you can do something as drastic as get back surgery, but this may not be the best option for you and could lead to other problems. So if you're looking for a better alternative to relieve your back pain, essential oils and aromatherapy just might be the natural relaxation treatment that you need. See, a lot of people I know suffer from lower back pain, and the root cause could be from having horrible body posture, or it could be from sitting or standing long hours each day, or having past injuries that can cause lower back pain. The pain can be extremely unbearable for those suffering from long-term back pain. See, back pain doesn't just go away, it builds up over time, causing chronic back pain and overall body stiffness. Back pain, or pain in general, is no fun at all, and it takes the enjoyment out of life. Living with chronic back pain and discomfort can undoubtedly take its toll on your emotions and could very well cause a state of depression. Now, the most effective treatment is to avoid injuring your back in the first place, but it might be already too late. One of the very best ways to stop back pain is to watch your weight. Now, being overweight can lead to chronic back pain, but back pain happens when your abdomen muscles become overstretched. And the weak muscles in those abs force the back muscles to take over in place of those flabby abdominal muscles. By keeping the abs fit, toned, and not being overweight, you can definitely save your back many injuries. Another example of back pain is when a woman is expecting a child. Now, the child is growing in her body naturally, extending the woman's back and abdominal area, where they will indeed feel the effects of back pain. And right now, you probably have a mental image of a pregnant woman standing with her hands held on her lower back. Some women even experience significant pain during pregnancy when the baby decides to sit on the sciatic nerve. Sitting on the sciatic nerve may result in severe crushing pain in the lower back, but fortunately this is just temporary and undoubtedly will decrease as soon as the infant is born. And also, to prevent injury at the workplace and at home, you should be mindful of picking up heavy items. Use a back brace at work and remember to keep your knees flexible and bent when picking up heavy objects. In other words, don't lock your knees and lift with your legs. Many people don't think much about picking up heavy items, they just go at them and pick up these items, straining their back and muscle tissues, leading to lower back injury. And after injuring your back, this could lead you to visit your physician or chiropractor more than you really want to for treatment and diagnosis. Now, you may even be required to take a training course on some of the prescribed medication for your back. You must protect your back at all times and be mindful of your spine. Never injure your back in the first place. But what if my back is already injured and I'm suffering from back pain? Well, now that you know some reasons that cause back pain, let's talk about how we can deal with back pain naturally through aromatherapy. Aromatherapy provides excellent benefits to easing back pain. Aromatherapy works well with yoga exercises and stretching workouts known as asanas. But first, always consult with your chiropractor, practitioner, medical professional, doctor before starting any workout program. Yoga exercises are terrific for the spinal column and most likely will be suggested by your medical professional anyway. But the alternative to visiting your doctor, obtaining the diagnosis and the treatment, is that you can use numerous natural essential oils and aromatherapy that can help ease body pain and soothe any discomfort. For example, studies show that using hot essential oils for massage therapies on your back can help you relieve back pain and treat many other ailments as well, such as stress, anxiety, insomnia, digestive problems, just to name a few. To use aromatherapies and essential oils properly, you can generate a hot and fragrant pain relieving bath, or use it as a local massage. You can roll it on your skin. You can inhale it with using diffusers, or create a compress and place it on the back or the area where you're feeling pain. Follow these simple techniques. For the bathtub, you want to add 10 drops of eucalyptus, which is excellent for pain relief in muscles and joints, and then you want to add 10 drops of peppermint, which is excellent for pain relief as well. You want to soak in the hot bath for at least 20 minutes to achieve the full therapeutic benefits. And if you're pregnant or planning on using essential oils, ensure that you always consider the safety precautions on the label. Technique 2, applied topically or rolled on as a massage oil. Roman or German chamomile is an excellent anti-inflammatory and is known for reducing muscle spasms. Lavender is suitable for many things, including relieving muscle pain. And rosemary has pain-relieving effects as well and is also a good anti-inflammatory. Now you want to take about 6 drops of the chosen oil and keep this mixture well blended with adding about 6 teaspoons of jojoba oil or olive oil. Test a small exposed area, let's say on the back of your hand, and dilute more as needed. But before diluting it any further, you should leave it on your skin for about 24 hours to see if any skin irritation develops. If not, you should be good to use it on larger areas of the body. Technique number 3 is another blend for a local massage. Now, it's not necessary to blend the oils together, but they do work better if you blend 2 to 3 complementary oils such as citrus, spicy, and floral. These are complementary and they give a more awesome aromatic fragrance. And step 1 is to choose a vegetable oil such as grapeseed oil, or you can try sweet almond oil or sunflower oil to provide your base. Step 2 is to combine your oils in a small amount. Shake well and try to add amounts to your hand to test effectively and see if there's any allergic reactions that might occur, and you can reduce as needed or add more if desired. Step 3 is you want to add no more than 5% wheat germ to maintain the massage blend you just created. And directions for this: you want to use this mixture to rub and press it against muscles or lymph nodes, which a massage therapist can do for you in any massage technique using deep tissue massage, Swedish massage, hot stone, and more. To improve blood circulation to the lower back area, you can apply black pepper, ginger, and marjoram. So how does aromatherapy even work? Well, when inhaled, applied topically or massaged into the body, essential oils become absorbed through the pores in the skin. They affect the system in 3 ways: pharmacologically, psychologically, and physiologically. The natural chemical in the essential oils takes up to about 90 minutes to fully extract with the body's chemistry, and you will experience the effects of being sedated, balanced, and or stimulated in the same way that drugs would do for you. For example, if inhaled, the essential aromatics signal the brain's limbic system. These affect the mind and emotions. And don't worry, the oils exit the body through normal secretions such as urine, sweat, feces, perspiration, and exhalation. And so I've dropped some links below in the description to some essential oils I recommend and that we've discussed today, along with some diffusers and other items to help you on your aromatherapy journey. So don't be shy to grab those and try these techniques and let me know in the comments how they worked for you. So in this video, we only focused on a few aromatherapy and essential oils that can help you with back pain, but essential oils and aromatherapy are used to address many other ailments, which we can discuss in another video. And as always, like, comment, and subscribe, and share this video with someone who needs it. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.